Hi everyone, it's Aunt Fernita, and we're studying Lesson 3, Crossing the Runaway River. The message is God gives us leaders to help us do great things for Him. Our memory verse this week is Joshua chapter 3, verse 5. The Lord will do amazing things among you. How do you feel when you wake up on a day when you know something exciting is going to happen? What if it's something you've never done before? Let's imagine how an Israelite boy may have experienced a very exciting day. Sunlight streamed through the tent flap, waking Heber. He stretched lazily for a moment before he remembered. Joshua said today was the day. Today the Lord would do something amazing. What would it be? Heber wondered. God had done amazing things for the Israelites. He'd heard hundreds of times about how God had parted the Red Sea and led the people out of Egypt. He had eaten manna every day of his life. It was amazing. Food every day without fail. And then, not long ago, an Israelite army had defeated those two kings, Sihon and Og. Yes, God had done some amazing things, Heber decided. But those things had all happened when Moses had been leading. Moses was dead now, and Joshua was their new leader. Was Joshua as good a leader as Moses? Heber wondered. Would God still do amazing things for the Israelites? Heber got up and stepped outside. It had rained a lot lately, and the days were getting warmer. The melting snow in the mountains raced toward the river. The Jordan River was a muddy, angry torrent high over its banks. Canaan, the Promised Land, was on the other side of it, and they had been camped here for 3 days. His thoughts were interrupted by his father's urgent voice. "Joshua is giving instructions," he said. "Come quickly." Joshua was already speaking when Heber and his father arrived. "The Ark of the Covenant will go into the Jordan ahead of you," he was saying. "You are to move out from your positions and follow it. As soon as the priests who carry the Ark of the Lord set foot in the Jordan, its waters flowing downstream will be cut off and stand up like a wall. The priests will remain in the middle of the river while the entire Israelite camp crosses. So break camp now and get ready."
"We have no time to waste," Heber's father said. Heber gulped down some manna as he helped to pack.
They soon heard the order to line up. Up ahead, he could see the priests carrying the Ark of the Covenant. Moving forward, they were leading the entire Israelite camp straight towards the rushing, roaring river. The priests didn't hesitate for a moment as they stepped right into the rapids. As soon as their feet touched the water, it stopped. The water came to a complete halt, piling up just as Joshua had said it would. The water downstream of the priests kept flowing away from them. In a matter of seconds, the water had disappeared around a bend. The priests moved to the middle of the river. A great shout went up from the Israelites.
Hey!
The line of people moved quickly to the riverbank. They began to pick their way across the rocky riverbed and up the other side. Heber couldn't take his eyes off the priests. His own family moved across the riverbed, over and around rocks. They tried to avoid the little puddles the river left behind. The priest still stood in the middle of the riverbed, still holding the ark high. The next thing Heber knew, he was scrambling up the bank into Canaan. Then he turned to watch while the last of the Israelites stepped into the Promised Land. Finally, the priests crossed. The instant the last priest cleared the banks, the waters broke loose. With a fearsome thunder, they resumed their mighty journey. It was over. As easily as that, their long journey was over. Heber sat down on the riverbank. He looked up at the fluffy clouds overhead. "There's no doubt," he thought. "God is with Joshua, just as he was with Moses. And I believe even more amazing things are still to come."
This podcast is read by Franita Buddy for Gracelink.net. Created and produced by Falvo Fowler. Post-produced by Faith Toe at Studio El Piso. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. Animation and artwork by Giogo Godoy. The audio engineer was Karel Holness. For more information, please visit gracelink.net.